See, he's a late. He's about here.
Later, he came back, and by then, not only did he still think I was the one, but I
I think that road you can come out of Barkerville, I think it is. How fucking people fly up and down here with a trailer doing about 90 clicks? I'm doing 60. See that dive of the motorhome? Between 120 and 140. Because we only had miles an hour.
98. That is You're Still the One by Shania Twain. Today we played it by special request for Debbie in Wallace, Idaho. Now wherever you are, right now, at home, at work, in the car, listening on the app, do you have that special song in your heart with that special memory attached to it? I am just a message away. Just go to Facebook, search two words, follow, fits, and in the subject, make sure it says music with memories. This is Bob Kingsley's Country Top 40, and we have 10 behind us and 30 left to count. Come on,
Bob. Oh, sweet.
Lately, Bryce says he helps his children learn to savor the important things in life.
Take your needs around you. You know, the potential all things that people do something. Well, I never, if you are too fast, you're not leaving.
What?
These days, kids.
No, that's just a mile marker.
16.
We're now faster, faster.
16? All right. That's Francois.
Decision to enjoy life. It's not worried and anxious. We need to have something else. Like, let's be thankful to God. You know,
true words. Among the many things Lee Bryce has to be thankful for is yet another it on its way up. At number 29, here's Lee Bryce with one of them girls.
Not bad. Lots of people out here this weekend? A lot of young people, or?
There's some young people.
No?
The old
caretaker?
Well,
or no, just after him?
No, just he's a little settlement up here, right?
Yeah.
Like the main house, with a song, and then there's the roads in behind. There's a couple other people living there.
Oh, Davey. The guy with the red Jeep. I think that's where he lives out there.
Hi.
Yeah, there's a lot of people going up the road. People coming.
It was like we come here.
Started to pack in.
We quit coming out here 4 years ago, 3-4 years ago. We came out here, there was about 80 young kids just shooting shotguns at 2 and 3 in the morning.
I had the grandkids with us.
I had a pack up at 4 in the morning.
Oh, Oh my god.
Well, that's just like our daughter came out last night with the grandchildren. And her boyfriend and we had a nice time. You know, we left today, but.
And we just came out to kind of stretch our legs and get away from the dog.
Yeah, we were picking up. Picking up friggin'.
That's what I hate is pulling into a campsite and you got another man's garbage piled all over the place.
Well, that's it.
Well, just a couple campsites down. There's somebody decided just to leave their broken
canopy. Their canopy's busted. And then further
on, that on Facebook.
2 weekends ago, we stayed at, going into Apache, but before you hit Apache.
Oh, the one that goes down in the hollow?
Yeah, it's
Grizzly.
Grizzly Lake?
No, Grizzly is
it's farther.
Yeah, you got to cross the river for that. But if you're, like, Apache is just, 5 kilometers up, 6 kilometers.
About that.
That's 241, I believe. But if you turn down the Apache Lake Road, like the campsite at Apache was kilometer two, but this is even before there. And it used to be a Métis thing, and years back, like we used to live on the Buckhorn, but I mean, there was old cars in there and shit like that. Eh? But it's cleaned up. We rebuilt the fire pit and raked and like.
Well, we cleaned this whole area.
Oh, yeah, I took my whippersnapper and cleaned this all up.
We cleaned it up.
Yeah.
And we'll leave it like that.
Just leave a campsite.
That's the way we do it. Rake it up, clean it up.
Yeah, and you just
we burn our garbage.
And then when we go to leave and the people next to us leave just before us and fucking garbage all over the place.
Yeah, you really shake your head. Yeah.
You know what the worst part was? Is years ago, we used to live out
Blackwater?
No, where we knew Jude. Out of Chase.
Yeah.
We were at a campgrounds, and the biggest pigs that were out there
Adams Lake.
Was literally the pigs, the clops. Oh. They had a big reunion thing. They left
and
a busted boat,
every site.
Food, rotting food all over the place.
And there's a garbage can right there.
Yeah.
In every side.
The only good part is I helped Jude clean it up. Somebody had left 3 flats of beer behind the bush.
I forgot all about them.
Sweet.
Yeah, if I had one of those claws, I'd be picking up friggin' toilet paper. There's toilet paper everywhere.
Too lazy to walk to the shit house.
There's a friggin' outhouse right there. I think there's three of them.
Or a bread bag. Yeah. And throw your crap in it, and when you're done, throw it in the fire.
Yeah.
But, well, when we got here, I swear to God, that was human stuff on
it. Like, probably. Yeah. Oh, I gotta stretch my legs. I've been bouncing around too much.
You cross the river, or you just come up to Buckhorn?
I just came up to Buckhorn. Yeah. We went down that other one there, off of Scott Road.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we went up through some of the trails up there.
Yeah, Snowmobile Club up there.
Yeah, but you know what's nice? That gate's open now. You can come back out onto Holmes Road.
Oh, yeah.
Pinko. Okay.
Pinko, and then you go to Holmes Road. But usually they have that gate
locked
off.
And the campgrounds there is open. And that's free camping. And it's clean in there.
Hey,
chicken. Hey. And that one on Scott Road in the campgrounds it's all clean.
Yeah.
It's been closed for about 3 years.
Yeah,
it's open now.
No way.
It's all nice and clean, nice sights.
We go to the snowmobile club. Before it, there's a campground in there.
Yeah.
Remember, it was all weeded over and looked like hell?
Yeah.
This year's nice.
Somebody got in there.
I met you guys before, too. Out of here.
Well, we lived down the Buckhorn.
Yeah.